If you think there might be something wrong with the graphics card in your computer, or you recently bought a new graphics card and you just want to test it for any errors to be sure that it is working properly, you can follow the steps that I'm going to be showing you in this video, because it's designed to detect any errors you might be having with your graphics card. So before we start, I'm going to assume that you already have the graphics card inserted into your computer and that it is working, and that you've connected your monitor to your computer and that you can basically see your desktop like you're seeing on the video now. The first thing you should have a look at is the device manager. So to access that, you can right click on the start button, then you can select device manager, and that's going to take you to this window where you'll have display adapters. And if you double click on that, it's going to show you all of the available display adapters that you have in your computer. Now, as you can see here, I've got an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3060, and the processor that I have in my computer does not have integrated graphics, but if it did, I would have two display adapters here. One of them would either be an Intel integrated graphics or an AMD integrated graphics adapter that I would have here. So if you're seeing that, it means you have integrated graphics in your processor as well. Now, you can still go ahead and follow the same steps, but if you have a graphics card that you want to test, like I mentioned at the start of this video, you'll either see an NVIDIA graphics card like I have here, or an AMD graphics card. Now, if you have that, you can go ahead and double click on it. And the first thing that you should be looking at is if the device status says that it is working properly. If it's not working properly, it already means there's something wrong with it, and that could be related to the driver that's not installed. So if I go ahead and click on the driver tab here, you can see that the driver for my graphics card is installed already. But if you haven't installed the graphics driver for your graphics card and you don't know how to do that, I'm going to link my dedicated step-by-step videos in the description of this video, so you can go ahead and follow that to get the latest driver installed for your specific graphics card. And then once you've done that, you can follow the steps that I'm going to be showing you in this video. Now, with that being said, if you encounter any issues during the driver installation of the graphics card, that it basically bombs out, or it doesn't complete, or it shuts down your computer, that also means something is wrong with the graphics card. Because by installing the driver, you're basically ensuring that the communication between Windows and the graphics card works properly. And if the driver installation fails, it means there is something wrong. But if you were able to successfully install the driver, and you have the device status set to the device is working properly, then we can go ahead and continue. So what I want you to have a look at is to see what graphics card you have. In my case, I've got an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3060. Now, with that in mind, you can go over to Google, and then you can do a search for the recommended power supply for your specific graphics card. Now, as you can see, according to HP, it's 550 watt. And if you have a look at some of these other results here, this post says 450 watt. This one says I wouldn't do anything less than 500 watt. Then MSI here says for the 3060 Ti, the minimum is 550 watt, and then you can go up from there. Now, in my computer, I've got a 650 watt, and it's basically about 100 watts more than the recommended power supply for this graphics card. So you always want to make sure that you have a little bit more wattage than the recommended power supply for that graphics card, because if your power supply is not giving enough power to the components, that can also cause some issues. But once you've determined all of that, you can go ahead and you can download FurMark, which is a GPU stress test application. Once you get to this webpage, if you scroll down, you're going to see that there's two versions, FurMark 2 and FurMark 1. And FurMark 2 is obviously the latest version. That's what we're going to go ahead and download. So I'm going to click on the download button here, and then we're going to download FurMark 2 for Windows. And in this video, I'm just going to use the Windows 64 zip file. I'm not going to be using the installer. And on this next page here, I'm just going to click on this massive download button, which will then start the download for that FurMark zip file. Then I'm just going to go ahead and show it in the downloads folder, which in my case is the desktop. Then, because this is a zip file, we'll need to extract it. So I'm just going to right click on it, then click on extract all, and then extract the application to the computer here. And it's automatically going to open the new window with FurMark inside of it. So if I open that folder, the file you're looking for here is the FurMark GUI executable file. So if I go ahead and double click on that, it's going to launch this FurMark window right here. So I'll just go ahead and minimize all of this. Now, if we go through these settings here, you can basically leave the graphics test on the default. Then for the resolution, you want to select your monitor resolution. So if we right click on the desktop here and we go to display settings, you can see that this monitor is set to 1920 by 1080. That's why I'll have 1920 by 1080 selected there. But if you click on this drop down here, you can also select a whole bunch of other resolutions, and it also goes up to 4K. And then in this next drop down here, you can select the graphics card that you want to test. So if you have more than one graphics card, you can select between them here, but I only have the one graphics card, which is the RTX 3060. Then you have some other checkboxes here where you can basically let it run in full screen as well. I'm not going to be checking any of these other boxes here. Next, you also have these applications that you can launch, which is GPU Shark, GPU Z, and then CPU Burner. I'm not going to be using that in this video. What I want to have a look at is actually testing the graphics card, running a stress test on it to determine if there's any issues. So to do that, you can just go ahead and click on run, and it's going to basically open it in the resolution that you selected and make it full screen if you selected your screen's resolution. Now, I'm recording on the same PC that I'm running the stress test on, so if it lags, that's why. But as you can see on the left here, it basically gives you the FPS that it's currently running at. But the things you need to have a look at is the temperature, and you want to see if the temperature rises and it gets too hot, that means there's something wrong. The card is not cooling itself properly. Then you can also see the usage it's under currently. Right now it's under 96% usage, but that is basically full load. And then the amount of VRAM that's in use, and also the amount of power that it's drawing. So right now it's drawing about 170 watts. And you also have some info with regards to the fans here and the fan speeds. So what you need to do now is basically leave this test for about 20 to 30 minutes so it can run. And in that time, you need to look and see if there's any artifacts on the screen, or if the test just bombs out and closes, or if the temperature rises too high, or if your computer just shuts down. All of that tells you there is something wrong with the graphics card. And I'm assuming while saying that, you've already followed the previous steps in this video. So your power supply is big enough, the graphics driver is installed successfully, and all of that's been sorted out. Now you're just doing the stress test to see which results you're getting. So right now we're about 3 minutes into this test, and the temps are still in the 60s. Which isn't bad. It means this graphics card is performing well. And I'm obviously not going to be letting it run for 20 or 30 minutes in this video. It's just going to take too much time. Like I mentioned, if you're seeing any artifacts, and by artifacts, it means weird lines on the screen, or the colors are turning weird, or the picture itself is just not being displayed like it was at the start, it all means there's most likely something wrong with the graphics card. And in that case, you can just go ahead and stop the test, and you can do that by pressing escape on the keyboard. And as you can see from this graph down here, the usage dropped down completely, and the temps are also dropping down gradually. Now, if you want, you can also run a benchmark with FurMark, but I'm not going to be doing that in this video. I just wanted to show you the process of elimination that you can follow to determine if there might be something wrong with the graphics card in your computer. If there's something wrong with your graphics card and you detected errors, or the test wasn't able to run for 20 to 30 minutes without any issues, it means you most probably need to replace your graphics card. Now, this video is part of a series of videos on my channel where I show you how to test different computer components. And if you want to have a look at the other videos, I'll leave a playlist to that down in the description of this video. But if you found any value out of this video, please give the video a like. And if you want to support the channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.